Hi everybody, welcome back. You might recall that when we discussed the syllabus, I mentioned that you'll be working on four different research reports. For each research report, you're going to collect data, and then you're going to use the tools that we learn in class to analyze that data using SPSS. Before you can collect data on your own, you have to pass IRB training and be certified. This training is specifically designed to teach you about research ethics. Before you can collect data from people, you need to understand basic principles regarding how to treat people and their data fairly. I'm going to show you how to do that right now. Ohio University sometimes moves the link to the training program that you must complete, so really the easiest way to find it is to just Google Ohio University CITI training. Ohio University CITI training. CITI stands for Collaborative Institutional Training Initiative. Once you find that, click on it. The very first search result should be what you want, Training Ohio University. Once you get to this OU page, scroll down just a little bit and you'll see a link to Collaborative Institutional Training Initiative. Click it. This is exactly where we need to be. Go ahead and click on Register. This training module needs to know who you are and which university you're affiliated with because different universities have different training modules set up. So the first thing we need to do is select our organization. You can start typing in Ohio University and that will come up. And then say that you agree and you affirm that you are an affiliate of Ohio University. At this point, you can say continue to create your CITI program username and password. I recommend that you take this seriously. Put in your true first name, last name, and your OU email address, because when it prints out your completion report, it will have that information on it. And for classes that you take later on, sometimes you need to have this training completed, and it will only be accepted if it has your complete name and your OU email address listed. I am already registered, but I want to show you how to do it, so I'm going to put in some fake names. So you need your first name, your last name, your email address, verify your email address, scroll down. You don't necessarily need to put in a secondary email address. You can continue then to step three. At this point, you need to create a username and a password. And then verify your password. You'll be able to list a security question, your pet's name, and then continue to step four. Enter in your country of residence. Now the CITI people want to know if they can contact you about other courses. I would rather not be contacted, so I list no. Then continue to step five. I would assume almost none of you are interested in receiving continuing education credit. If you are interested in that, you would already know, but for almost all of you, you're going to say no. Go ahead and scroll down and continue to step six. Language preference. English. Institutional email address. Again, put in your OU email address. Verify that email address. And then enter in this basic demographic information. For department, you can put in psychology. What is your role in research? You can put down student researcher, undergraduate. No need to put in any address. It forces you to put in an office phone number. If you'd like, you can put in 740-588-1000. And then continue to step 7. Scroll down just a little bit to see your options. At this time, I wish to take human subjects training required for IRB submission. Click Next. Scroll down a little bit. Click on Group 2, Social and Behavioral Investigators and Key Personnel. Click Next. That's pretty much all it takes to get registered. Now just click on Finalize Registration. Because you've registered and because you've created a username and a password, you can start the training, and at any point you can stop, log yourself out, and then later on log back in and complete the training. Let's look at the training modules. Scroll down a little bit. It says Institutional Courses, Ohio University. Select View Courses. You'll see it says Courses Ready to Begin. Group 2, Social and Behavioral Investigators and Key Personnel. That's what we selected. It's a basic course. There are 9 modules. You can click on Start Now. You can just read through the basic terms and agree to them, and then click Submit. If you scroll down a little bit, you'll see the different modules that you need to complete. And in order to get started, just click the Start button on any particular module. After you complete all of the required modules, you'll see that there are some supplemental modules, but you don't need to complete them. Your goal is to complete the required modules and then print your 2-page completion report. Let me show you an example of what that completion report looks like. After you pass the required modules, you'll be given an opportunity to print your completion report. You'll also be given an opportunity to save it as a PDF file. There are 2 important pages. Page 1 looks like this. It lists who you are. It lists the training modules that you completed, and it also shows your score. And then when you move on to page 2, it says part 2 of 2, you'll see a coursework transcript. And here's just a little bit more detail about the modules that you completed. You're going to want to print both pages. The training is actually really interesting, really informative, and it's necessary for you to begin collecting data. So make sure you have it done by the due date. If you have any questions, just let me know. I'll see you in the next video. In the meantime, be safe.